Today we're joined by Dr. Mingying Xiang, who is our new Extension Turfgrass Specialist. And Dr. Xiang, welcome to your first premiere episode of Oklahoma Gardening. We're going to talk about fertilizing Bermudagrass because I know everybody's grass is starting to green up. So how do we manage fertility?
So fertilization is one of the very important practices to keep your grass green, like darker green color, uniform and higher density, and especially for your grass has been like properly fertilized, they can fight against like drought stress, heat stress much better than those grass haven't got properly fertilized. So this time of the year, we definitely need to start thinking about fertilize your Bermuda grass.
Right, a lot of times we think, well, that just makes it mow and more work for us, but it's important for its health as well. So
yes,
that's a good point. So if a person goes to a garden center, there's usually a lot of options. How do they know where to even start?
The first step we will start with is do a soil test. If you need more information, contact your county extension agent. A good soil test is going to give you a guideline regarding if you need phosphorus and potassium and how much. Many homeowners find out from their soil test they don't even need phosphorus and potassium, so they can save money, just go with something like this one, 4600, like only has nitrogen.
Right, that first number is nitrogen, right?
Yeah, the first number is nitrogen. So if you feel like you don't need to waste money on your P and K, just go with pure nitrogen.
And that's why it's so important to do that soil test initially.
Yes, so our recommendation is to do it every 3 years.
Okay.
But I do understand many homeowners don't have access to do a soil test. And then our recommendation is to pick up something has 3:1:2 ratio.
Okay.
So for example, a 15:5:10 fertilizer will be a good choice. So it's called complete fertilizer. So
okay,
you don't need to worry about deficient like phosphorus or potassium.
Okay, excellent information. And of course, so based off of a soil test, then you're going to figure out which nitrogen or which fertilizer to choose. How often are we doing this in our yard?
Yeah, that's a very good question. Even though soil tests will give you information regarding potassium and phosphate, but you really don't know about your nitrogen. It mm-hmm. depends on the species.
Okay.
And it depends on the soil type and your management practice. And when we talk about the nitrogen fertilizer, there are two different types based on how quick they can release. They can be available. So we call it fast release nitrogen source and slow release nitrogen source.
Mm-hmm.
If you go with the fast release nitrogen source, it's only available for about 30 days.
Okay.
And our recommendation is if you go with that way, do a like lower rate and more frequent application.
Okay.
Because 30 days later, the nitrogen is not available. So you want to do a reapplication using quick release.
So of course, we're talking warm season, which is completely different than cool season. So we're looking from April through, you know, late summer. Is that the timeline?
Yeah, we normally do like late April or early May all the way to mid September or so.
Okay. So that's monthly for quick release. What about a slow release fertilizer?
Yeah, slow release fertilizer means it makes the nitrogen slowly available to the grass. So you could do a higher rate, maybe a pound and a half of nitrogen every time and do it every 6 to 10 weeks.
Okay.
But the drawback for slow release nitrogen is it's more expensive,
okay,
but it keeps you on a like less frequent schedule. So save you some labor.
Okay, so for a slow release, a pound and a half every 6 to 8 weeks, and then is it a pound for the monthly quick release of actual nitrogen?
Yeah, we don't recommend anything above 1 pound of nitrogen because quick release fertilizer has very high burning potential. So
okay,
if you apply it in a hot summer, you do want to make sure you water them in immediately,
okay,
to avoid burning of your grass.
Okay, and then like even I've even heard, you know, dew in the morning, if that
mm-hmm.
Urea might get on that dew, it can burn the foliage.
Yes.
So that's why you really want to get it infiltrated into your soil profile.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. So how do we go about like actually applying it? You've got a couple of application methods here. Tell us about this.
So it depends on how big is your yard.
Okay.
If you have a very, very small yard, the handheld spreader will be a good choice for a small area of yard.
Okay.
But The drop spreader could also be a good option. So it only drop as you go, but you do want to pay a good attention on your previous pass. So you do want to make sure you have a good coverage pass by pass.
Okay, because especially on that quick release, you're going to see green stripes if you don't.
Exactly. Like I see people like do a like application like a McDonald's shape. So you're going to see it.
You'll see it. Okay,
yes.
Excellent. And then this is a rotary?
This is a rotary spreader. So it's very good for a larger area of yard. So it's spread all around and you can get a very good coverage and overlap. But be very careful regarding like what kind of fertilizer do you use. If you use a fertilizer that has various particle size or it's broken particle in the bag or it has lots of dust, this rotary spreader will give you some poor distribution because those larger, heavier particles will be thrown farther away compared to those smaller particles. So you do want to make sure you apply when the wind doesn't catch those smaller particles. You want to split your application into at least two applications so they can get a good, better coverage. But if you have something really have very different particle size, the drop spreader will be a better choice.
Okay. And I know one of the concerns about this is it potentially getting on your sidewalks also, right?
Yes.
We're not trying to fertilize the concrete.
Exactly. It's very common with rotary spreader. It goes to the pavement. And what we normally do is you do a very good cleaning up. Either use your blower, blow your fertilizer back to the soil, your grass, or just do a clean up using your broom and put it back to your lawn.
Well, thank you so much for all of this information. I know it'll get us off to a great spring.
Thank you.
Check out this fact sheet for more information.
We hope you enjoyed this video as part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on the OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.